Welcome to the first of the five-part video series on 26 essential but less known PowerPoint tips that make you look like a PowerPoint wizard. We have a tip for every alphabet. Let us dive right in. I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. We share creative PowerPoint ideas to help professionals like you create engaging presentations. A is for autocorrect. Let us say you have a presentation on atherosclerosis. What this means is you'll be writing this long and complex word multiple times in your presentation. This is not only painful, but is also error prone. I have a cool trick that allows you to write these long and complex words quickly and effortlessly. I call it the autocorrect hack. For that, you double click on the complex word that selects the word, right click and copy, go to File, go to Options, and then go to Proofing and say autocorrect options. There you have two boxes, replace and with. In replace, choose a simple string of letters that you can type easily. In this case, I'm going to use AAA, and then I'm going to replace it with the complex word. Since I've already copied the complex word, I'm going to use the shortcut Ctrl V to paste the complex word and say add and say OK. Now I'm going to close this by saying OK. Now, whenever I want to type atherosclerosis, I just need to say AAA and hit a spacebar, and atherosclerosis is done. It's that easy. AAA spacebar. B is for blank screen. Let us say you have a lot of side talks and murmurs during your presentation. You see that your audience is not paying attention to you. So how do you get their attention back to you in an instant? It's simple. While you are in the slideshow mode, hit the letter B on your keyboard and then remain silent. B will make your screen go blank like you're seeing now, and your silence will break the pattern of the audience, which means they will instantly turn their attention back to you. Once their attention is back, you hit B again or you hit Enter and the slideshow resumes. It is my go-to technique when I have a distracted audience. It works like a charm every time. C is for crop pictures to shape. Pictures in a rectangular shape are too common and boring. They can be easily ignored. Whereas pictures in a circular shape are uncommon and they instantly demand attention. They look stylish as well. The question is, how do you crop your pictures into a circular shape, a star shape, or any other shape you desire? It's fairly simple. Let me show you how. First, select the picture, go to Picture Format, go to Crop, go to Crop to Shape, and choose your shape. Let me choose the first one called Oval Shape. Then, let me go to Crop, go to Aspect Ratio, and choose 1:1 so that the dimensions are constrained. We have cropped a rectangular picture into a circular shape. Now, if I want this to be in a star shape, all I need to do is to select the same picture, go to Crop, go to Crop to Shape, and under Stars and Banners, choose the star you want and you have the picture cropped in star shape. D is for default text box. Now let us insert text using text box. Let me go to Insert, Text Box, and write my text. I'm going to say default. Now you can see that the default text box has Calibri font in 18 font size. Now let me make some changes to this text box. I'm going to change the font type to something else, like say 2cm empty condensed extra bold. I'm going to increase the font size. Let me underline this and let me change the font color to say orange. Now I've done a lot of work to stylize this text inside the text box. Now what if I wish every time I insert a text box in this presentation that the text appears in the same stylized format? Is it even possible? Yes, it is. Let me show you how it is done. Let me right click on this text box, go to Set as Default Text Box option. Now the job is done. Let me insert a new text box. Click, write your new text. Can you see here? The new text box has the same stylized format as the previous one. Before I go to the next tip, here is a useful resource for you. If you want to have a strong foundation in PowerPoint, then you will really love this course called Complete PowerPoint Foundation Course. it is a 13.5 hours course which gives you all the foundation you need to create awesome presentations. I will leave a link to this course in the description box below the video. E is for embed your fonts. Let's say you designed your slides using a beautiful font that adds a stylistic value to your presentation. You then copy your presentation to a pen drive, go to the presentation room and load your presentation onto the laptop in the room. Then when you open your presentation, to your horror, you discover that the fancy font that you used in your presentation is no longer visible. It is replaced by some other dud font automatically by PowerPoint. Why does this happen? It happens because the beautiful font that you installed on your computer is not available on the computer that you are using now in the presentation room. To avoid this issue, whenever you use custom font on your slides, you need to embed the font in your presentation. It's fairly simple. You go to File, go to Options, under Save, you have this option called Preserve Fidelity when sharing this presentation, and you have this option called Embed Fonts in this file. You check that and you say OK. Now your font is embedded in this presentation. This means you can share your presentation with anyone, or you can show the presentation on any computer and your fancy fonts will show. If you like the tips in this video, then you will also like the 9 time-saving PowerPoint tips and tricks that are shared in this video. It is already popular with more than 274,000 views. So click on the link here and watch the video and enjoy the practical tips.